Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover how to set up the ASIO for All audio driver to get low latency sound in a digital audio workstation. The ASIO for All driver allows lower latency than typical audio outputs from our computer and also allows us to use certain audio interfaces such as those from Behringer. Not all audio interfaces will work with this driver though, since some require their own audio driver. The first thing to do is go to the ASIO for All website and download and install the audio driver on our computer. All the settings for ASIO for All are then accessed through our Digital Audio Workstation's audio interface setup in the Preferences. We'll do this in both Reaper and Cakewalk by BandLab. Let's start with Reaper. To access the audio interface settings, go to the Options menu at the top and select Preferences. Then open Devices under Audio. We need to set the audio system at the top to ASIO. Then we can set the audio driver to ASIO for All. To access the settings for ASIO for All, click the ASIO configuration button down below. This brings up our driver settings. Here we can see all the audio hardware connected to our computer and select what we want to use. We use the plus buttons on the side to expand them and view all the inputs and outputs, then the power buttons to turn them on or off. The only other setting we need to worry about is the ASIO buffer size. With a low buffer, we get less latency, but there's a higher chance of audio glitches like pops or clicks. You may want to experiment with this on your system to get the buffer size right. The entire process for using the ASIO for All driver is very similar in Cakewalk by BandLab. With the program opened, we go to the Edit menu at the top and select Preferences. Then we go to Playback and Recording under Audio and set the driver mode to ASIO. Then go to Devices and make sure to deselect any other drivers and select the ASIO for All driver. If there's another driver in use, you won't be able to select the ASIO for All driver and it will be locked out since only one type of device can be used at once. Check off all the ASIO for All inputs and outputs that we'll be using. Now switch to driver settings. Here we can open the ASIO panel and get the same ASIO for All settings we talked about in Reaper. The first way to use this audio driver that we'll cover is with an audio interface like the Behringer UM2. When we connect it, it doesn't come with its own driver, so it relies on the ASIO for All driver to work with a digital audio workstation. Another way to use it is to reduce the latency of our built-in sound card. That way we can use things like MIDI controllers with low latency with our sound card as an ASIO device. Otherwise, trying to use a MIDI controller without ASIO will be impossible due to the high latency. Thanks for checking out this video on using the ASIO for All audio driver in a digital audio workstation on Windows. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for links to social media accounts to stay up to date on all our new content.